has existed for an insignificant blink of that time.
Darwin's wife, Emma, used to play to him on the piano in this very room, and Darwin would lie on the sofa and listen. It's not clear how much he got out of it, though, because it was once said of him that he was so tone-deaf that people had to nudge him to stand up when they were playing God Save the Queen. But anyway, I want to use this piano to illustrate the vastness of geological time, and yet how comparatively little of it is occupied by those animals and plants that we know anything about. If we have the origin of life at the bottom of the piano there, and recent times at the top, I find it astonishing that we have nothing but bacteria all the way up here, past Middle Sea, way up to about here, when more complicated cells than bacteria first evolve. And then we get the first many-celled animals, the first large animals somewhere here. Fish start around here. The dinosaurs don't come in until about here. And then the extinction of the dinosaurs around here. About here, the apes and monkeys. And the whole of human history would occupy a space less than the width of one piano string right at the top of the keyboard.